Good afternoon, one and all. Worthy principals, eminent personalities, our panelists, and dear colleagues. I, on behalf of Times of India and Team NI, welcome you all to Times NI Principles webinar. I also take this opportunity to thank Birla Brainiacs for joining hands with us. I'm sure in this previous 1 year, we have heard one word the most, which is COVID. Besides that, we have also heard two more words the most. One is virtual. You just prefix virtual before anything and we are good to go. And the other word, I don't know, but it is related to COVID, which is coding. It has become as contagious as COVID. And if we don't know coding, probably we are doing some crime. So I once again welcome all of you to this webinar for understanding whether coding is a skill which is really needed, or it is just a career fad. May I request my colleague Sugandha to please take us through this webinar. Thank you.
Thank you, Vishalji. I would like to introduce our eminent panel, which is present here to brainstorm on whether coding is required by this generation or not, and how much of it is really required. We have with us Padmashri Professor G.D. Yadav, Emeritus Professor of Eminence, J.C. Bose National Fellow, Government of India, former Vice Chancellor and R.T. Modi Distinguished Professor and Tata Chemicals Darbari Seth Distinguished Professor of Innovation and Leadership, Institute of Chemical Technology, Mumbai. Welcome, Yadav sir. Yadav sir brings with him immense teaching experience, immense administrative abilities, and a deep insight into science as a stream of education, as a stream of research. Welcome, Yadav sir. I would request him to address this august audience.
Thank you so much, Sugandha. She asked me to participate in this webinar, which is attended by principals and school authorities and others, I was a little bit surprised because I'm a chemical engineer by profession, but of course I have done a lot of computer programming in my research and innovation. So when she said that, is coding really a fad or it is required? So I would say that, you know, coding is required by whom? Who are the people? Are they already well-qualified engineers, graduates who understand science, they understand the language of coding, whatever you may call? Because these days we are talking about data analytics, information technology, Python, R, Java, Linux, C++, whatever. And we have to communicate with the computer by using these skills. Of course, in any profession, because what is happening today's world is an electronic world, so e-world, right? So we make use of electron to connect with everything, which may not be near us, it may be far away. So obviously, this is a technique which is used as a complementary thing, and it is not going to substitute that job per se. It is going to help the person, those who are already well, qualified, know what they want to do. They have to analyze a lot of data, which obviously they can do it. But, in some cases, you normally hear on the television, a kid, sixth or seventh standard kids is going to do coding and all sorts of things. I think that is humbug because it requires a lot of mathematical background, analytical mind. And so you cannot just introduce some young kids as if you are playing with WhatsApp messages. That's not coding, okay? Coding is a high level science. So obviously people are going to make use of that, give instructions to the computer, and the computer will analyze data. So there is a lot of data behind, a lot of data which are there collected. In any field, though, there will be data and you have to analyze them. So for analysis of those data, you require certain programming languages, certain codes, and that is what it, if you mean by coding, yes, like C++, all our students do that. Or Python is one of the languages, or many other languages like MATLAB and you name it. So what I'm trying to drive at is that coding is a highly specialized job, which will be required, like you know, earlier people never used computers, but everybody these days is using computers, right? So it is a tool. It is not a substitute for the job, it is a tool. So as a tool, yes, we can make use of that to enhance our skill, analyze the data and take proper decisions. In that regard, it is okay. But introducing coding to young kids who don't understand any basics of mathematics is foolish. Thank you.
Thank you, Yadav sir, for a very short yet meaningful demystification of coding as a career. We have with us now Gurpreet Kaur Chadha. Her involvement evolves into a lifetime commitment to educating people and assisting people, a single mother of two young children, a participant of GLADRAG's Mrs. India 2008. She believes in giving back to the society. She is an actor, producer, a socialite, and an active politician, vice president of the Mahila Congress Mumbai, an ex-advisory panel member of the Film Censor Board, MTNL, founder of Punjabi Global Foundation, among others. Gurpreet ji, welcome to this eminent panel. I would now request her to share her thoughts with this audience.
Hi, everyone. Good afternoon. And it's a beautiful time I'm here and with all of you, with my panelists, GD Yadav ji and sir. It's such a great honor to be with you all. And I'm very happy to see so many principals actively participating in this webinar. And I was a teacher by profession for 12 years in Delhi Ramjas Day Boarding School. So as nowadays I'm very busy as a social worker. I'm on, like, you know, all the time on phone, helping people arranging sometimes oxygen, vaccines, beds, everything. So when I got a call from Times of India for this webinar, I could not say no. The reason is that the topic was quite interesting. Coding, is coding a skill? One. And I recently did an ad film also for Clever Harvey, which was also based on coding. So I was quite interested to join this webinar. So I'll be looking forward to ask many, if you want to ask anything from me on this topic. And Mr. Upadhyay, it's such a great honor to have you with me. So let's all discuss and share our thoughts here. Thank you.
Thank you, Gurpreet ji, for that very short and meaningful introduction as well as welcome address. Shweta Upadhyay, CEO of Brainiacs, is with us here. Shweta is a serial entrepreneur, having an experience of 20 years in global education and brings rich product design experience to this forum. He is a pass out of IIT Kharagpur in robotics and automation, and has held chief executive positions with global leaders in the education sector. He has worked with Infosys and Kyoshi Japan and is currently heading Birla Brainiacs. Welcome, Shwetang sir, to this audience, and we would like to hear your views on coding.
It's my honor to be here. Thanks, Sugandha, and thank you, Yadav sir, and thanks, Gurpreet ma'am. To be here. It's really an honor to share the forum with you guys, the personalities like you. And my views on coding is basically right now in current situation, coding has been hyped a lot actually. Okay, it has been used like a marketing tactic. Means I remember my previous day when I was preparing for IIT. But that time we used to prepare in 11th, 12th. Now I'm seeing the kids preparing for IIT from the sixth standard. And now I have seen the coding from the grade one, as Yadav sir was telling me. So this is something actually which is mainly leveraging on the fear of the parents, I would say, in a very short thing. Coding skill is required. Coding as such is not required. So there's a big difference between these two things. And I completely agree, because by that time, these students from grade one to graduation, and they were actually going to use, as Yadav sir was mentioning, that for data analysis and all those things. The whole coding means languages tool will be completely changed. And there is so much of AI coming into the picture, artificial intelligence, that maybe like coding will not be required for 10% of just what is being done today, actually. So now we have to identify that what is exactly required. Is it a coding or coding skill? So today, my objective of being here is to clarify that confusion, that what is coding skill and what is a coding, and how it can be actually. Because see, one thing we have to keep in mind, National Education Policy, they have introduced the coding in curriculum now. So there's definitely a lot of thought process behind it. So let's try to understand what is the thought process behind that and why it is being introduced at such a low level, low grades, basically. Okay, so that is the whole idea to be here. I hope I would be able to help.
Yes, I think to begin with, it has been quite enlightening. What we would like to know from you, sir, is in today's fast-changing environment, okay, we see technology undergoing rapid changes. How important or relevant is it to learn coding part one, and particularly when coding language tools are changing so fast? Shwetang sir, would you like to answer?
So basically, see, when I was working with Infosys in 2003, last I was working 2003-2004, so by that, then whatever I used to do in Java and all those things, if I go back and when I see it over there, hardly, I mean, 10% is being required to do it now. So 10,000 of lines of code can be now just simply written in one command. So language and tools are changing very fast. There's no point in teaching those languages to the students, okay, or those tools, because they will be completely changing in this fast environment. Forget about by the time he will be graduating. I'm saying that if suppose some student is in eighth grade today, and by the means he is coming to the 12th grade, the complete technology and languages will be different. You just see from the last 5 years also, you will realize that how fast it has changed. So the required thing is not about the coding, but the algorithmic thinking behind it, how to solve those problems, how to fundamental, like when I I would say like mathematics behind it. So for example, what we have done is we have integrated we have explored the Vedic maths, and then we identified, okay, if we use Vedic maths in our writing our algorithms, it becomes very efficient. So what we have to understand is the mathematics, not the language. When you're writing a search algorithm, okay, how to make it optimize, that is the logic behind it, not the the language is not important. Same thing can be written in the Java, C++, or Python, or anything actually. But a logic is something which we have to introduce to the student. And this is what is called 21st century skill, actually. And that is why it is being introduced at the so lower grades, basically. Yes, Sugandha, I hope this answers.
Yes. Thank you, Shwetang sir. Yadav sir, would you like to share your thoughts on artificial based intelligence? You know, a lot of coding tools are coming up which write coding, the whole code automatically after getting the problem statement. So in such a scenario, will the coding skill be an essential? Yadav sir?
Sir, you are on mute.
Sorry. You know, I thought there would be disturbance, so I muted myself. It's a very good question. If the artificial intelligence is going to take over the natural intelligence, then what do we do? That means human being will be controlled by machine. You see some of these science fictions. But quite honestly, It is proven by, you know, the neurologists, neurobiologists, that human brain cannot be simulated by artificial intelligence. It can do faster calculation. That is true. By 2030, you know, the parallel processing and all that can certainly do faster than what we think. But, you know, human mind is highly chaotic. It will be wandering in several different places. So artificial intelligence cannot substitute human brain. Okay, that is my personal belief also. And many scientists do believe that. So that is number one. Number two, as you know, was said, you know, that, you know, if the languages are going to change, only the structure, how to develop that structure, the logical thinking to go to that. It is like that going from one place to another place. Like I go from Matunga to say your Times of India office in port. You know, I may fly, I may go by motorbike, or I may walk, but the ultimate destination is that. What do you use? So, you know, in coding, we see it like many languages are there. Look at Python and C++ or Java and many others. Earlier, we used to study Fortran and BASIC and whatnot. All those languages have just simply disappeared. But the thinking, the structure has remained the same. It has not changed. So how you do it, how fast you achieve the goal, that is what is meant by coding. I'm all for it. But remember, across the world, the data show that, you know, 90% of the people who are doing this coding, so-called inverted comma coding, have at least a bachelor's degree. That means their fundamentals, their mathematical basis, they are all sound. Otherwise, they can't do it. It is not copy-paste job. It is not copy-paste job. So I think artificial intelligence may help us in reducing the work. Okay, and right now, instead of you, Sugandha, there could be a robot there and asking me questions. Okay, that may happen. That may happen, but the robot has to find out questions on the basis of analyzing me, my behavior. It's like, you know, many times we know that Google, you know, sometimes when you start typing, it already completes the sentence.
Sir, may I add something here? Just got a thought, actually. So what you have pointed out is very true. The coding can be replaced by the AI tool, but the coding skills cannot be replaced by the AI tool, because it is a human brain, and coding skill requires human brain. When you say, can AI is going to replace the coding? Yeah, AI can support coding. That it will ask you, okay, you are trying to write a Boolean search, or you're trying to write a FTP file code. It will suggest you automatic code and everything. But as sir has mentioned, that if it is going from point one to two, then human brain has to write that logic.
And that's in fact, I will add, in United States, they have found the lawyers will not be required, because the artificial intelligence lawyer can give you better judgment and how to fight your case than the lawyer himself. So that is happening, but the data have been already analyzed by the machine. So the collection of data has to be there. Somebody has to put in the data. Correct. Otherwise, it will not happen. So it may be the collection of data, the manner in which these data are collected. You know, so earlier they used to have the so-called SAS, you know, the statistical information analysis. Those kind of things will remain. They are not going to change. What will change is the manner in which, and the tools which we use to do that particular job. Okay. So that is definitely going to happen, but basic skills will always remain basic skills.
Correct.
So can I add something? So there's a very famous quote by Steve Jobs: "A computer is a bicycle for your mind." Right. So nowadays all the parents want is that their parents should be their children should be the excellent problem solvers, and they should be ready to face any adversity in the life. So for that, I think code gives that chance to the children to learn and to tackle their problems. That skill is needed. What I feel as a parent is good.
It's a very good point, actually. In fact, Gurpreet ji, one very, you can observe as a parent also, it is all about the exposure to the child.
Yes.
If you give them the exposure, they learn new things.
Yeah.
Okay. So the objective is not to think okay they are going to be next Steve Jobs or Bill Gates. Okay. It is not about that. Okay. It is about you give them the exposure so that by the time they come to the actual learning path of whatever field they have selected, they have that kind of aptitude. See, coding develop. See, mathematics develop like logical reasoning. Similarly, problem solving. Similarly, coding also develops algorithmic thinking, logical reasoning, and problem solving. So,
how to communicate?
How to communicate? So these things become so important, and that's why it is being put it in the curriculum. Not for any like India wants to develop all its population as a software engineer. That is very wrong perception, and that is the thin line between the company using as a marketing and the actual facts.
Yeah,
that is the we have to be very careful about it actually.
Because I feel that it's with all the fields, you know, I am very active on Instagram and social media, and there I see that a lot of parents are approaching me that if their kids are doing well as a dancer, small kids, 5-6 year old kids, if they are doing well as dancers, they will ask me that please promote them. They want to go for the reality shows. They want to do something in life. So it's with all the fields. Like nowadays, it's the more challenging job for the parents. It's the competition.
Actually, in any area, forget about the coding, in dancing, mathematics, IITJ, doctor, it is not the time like for a fourth grade, fifth grade to like push him into one particular direction. That is not something is a good idea, actually.
Actually, this is a result of inferiority complex among the parents.
Yeah.
The parents think that because they did not get it themselves, they did not study in the best of the school, English medium school. They think their son or daughter should study in English medium school so that they can speak fluently and they will get a better job. Unfortunately, it doesn't happen that way. It doesn't happen. The parents are more, the parents. The parents think that. Yes, it is nice to know that the kids should have the best of the education, but they should be the like Sachin Tendulkar, Virat Kohli, yes. Shah Rukh Khan, all molded into one entity.
Yeah.
That cannot happen. And that is the problem. Actually, it is more problem, you know, as a head of the institute, as a vice chancellor, I realized that parents were more concerned about the kids than the kids themselves. Because they thought that if they do not intervene, which is very normal in India, parents intervene a lot. They don't allow the kids to think independently. Absolutely. So that is what is happening. Coding is the same thing, because everywhere they see the coding advertisement, you know, doing this and that, this kid is started and like some coaching classes. So they think coding is something new, okay? They don't understand anything what is meant by coding. But they think their kids should get that. It's like going to English medium school.
So here I wish to add one thing that every time I go to the schools, I tell the parents one thing, let explore the talent of your child. What the child wants to do. It's not important that a doctor's kid will always become a doctor. My mom was a teacher. She always wanted me to become a teacher. Somehow I became also. For her, but then later I chose my my path according to me. So it's always there. If the kids are interested in doing something, then only you force them. Otherwise, please don't put pressure on the children. Even if it's a competitive world, still also I feel.
The world requires all professionals.
Yeah.
It does not require only engineers or doctors or IIT graduates.
Absolutely.
Okay. There are so many beautiful and nice vocations. Professions outside. So parents should allow their kids to study what they like rather than forcing them and making them madcaps.
Absolutely.
Okay, ultimately, they become, mentally they get disturbed because, I know that many times people used to come to me and they said, sir, my kid did not get admission to your institute here because that time it used to be 98-99%, okay, in PCM. Oh, he got only 97. 97 is also very good. It is not good. So what I'm trying to tell you, we compare our kid with the neighbor's kid. And if the neighbor's kid is smarter than our kid, we say, our kid is useless. And we make the kid really a rotten kid. I think this is very wrong in India. As an administrator, as a professor, I have realized that we are not telling our kids to, you know, strengthen their own hobbies and what they are good at, rather than what they don't have. It's like that, you know. A monkey should only climb the tree, not an elephant.
Absolutely.
Sir, one thing actually, I mean, so the government has given a very clear mandate. Okay, when they have introduced it as a subject, okay, they haven't said that this is the most important subject in your curriculum. Yes. They included it like a subject: English, Math, Science, History, Geography, Coding. Okay, so it should be taken in that spirit. Okay, this is another subject. Okay, now learn it. See, nobody when learning the suppose mathematics is not like okay, you become like an accountant, or when you are going for the English literature in the sixth grade, not everybody is asking you to become the Shakespeare of the world. So what is happening is basically that they are picking up one subject and then making it a very hype of it, like this is the most important thing. See, which we have also done to some extent with the English, Math, Science. Okay, this is like, when I say we, our generation basically, which says these are the three prime subjects. So we have categorized it little better than geography, history and other. Okay, this is all because it is linked to our career path. So now as the topic is like whether it is a career fair. So what they have basically taken, okay, coding, that means software engineer, and that's the highest salary. Okay, so this is wrong. Okay, deciding the career of the student at a grade six and this is wrong. What you have to focus is, as he's performing good in the English, Math, Science, equally he should be performing in the coding also, because that is also one skill.
No, actually, there is a lot of hype. For example, somewhere you read IIT graduate XYZ IIT got 1.5 crore. They don't understand the, you know, where is that 1.5 crore? What is that value in New York and Mumbai or Delhi? So all other parents feel useless. They think their kid is useless because the kid from IIT got it. And also the newspapers are responsible for highlighting that only as a headline. Yeah. First print. I think they should not do it. Because every other profession is important. Initially, somebody might get high salary depending on where that person is being placed. If he's placed there, you will definitely require more than a crore if you are going to stay in a very expensive city in the Western world. But what I'm trying to tell you is that the colleges, the principals and all, like you already said, coding is just one subject like any other subject, like geography, history, sociology, okay, psychology, whatever we study. So study, if you are interested, develop your mathematics and go and do career, not otherwise. And it should be taken like IT was taken. It's a complimentary thing to your profession. It is not you can't do well.
I can see one question coming over here, that why should we teach each and every child coding?
Yeah, Mamta Goel has asked that question. Yeah. Yes, sir.
Yeah, please take it. It's a very interesting question, answer, actually.
You can answer the question, why should we teach each and every child coding? That is exactly what is being discussed here. And
the complete question is that too, from the primary level.
Yeah,
okay, so,
what is the need?
Yeah, so I'll tell you one thing. The one mistake which everybody has done, I would say, I'm taking the liberty that even for the government level also, the subject name should not be coding. Okay, that is the whole confusion about this actually. See, in the primary grade level one, the student is expected to look for the basic aptitude. Okay, is he able to predict something? What coming next? Okay, or he's able to put the things in the sequence. Okay, those are the primary things which are being taught to the grade level one, okay, or primary level student. Now coding, if you, as soon as you say coding, in our mind it goes like a Java and all those languages and tools. See, coding at that level, when we take it up, it is more like a solving puzzles, okay, where he has to predict the next thing. So whatever as a pedagogically, whatever is required at that age, that has to be taught. Now that is not available in all the subjects. So that's why the coding word has been, means coding is introduced over there, but that is not the coding as such, which we understand in the regular language. Okay, we are not going to teach in the mobile app development, website development in grade one. This is not required at all. Okay, so your question is right that coding, if you see in the literal meaning, it is not required. I also say, but as even we are teaching, Build Up India is also teaching coding in the primary level one. But then it is a completely different thing. It is skills, and skills cover your prediction, puzzles, drag drop to solve basic puzzles, do basic animation. So that is what is more like children enjoy, and that develops their mind. Okay, it is not about the coding.
I will give a rejoinder to that. Does it mean that it is an old wine in new bottle, that whatever we were studying earlier under some different name is being pushed under the throat of the kids as coding, and it does not require any other skills? So it is according to me, primary level, the kids must learn civic sense. Okay, very important. Very important. Civic sense, moral values, and things like that. Coding as just pastime or entertainment, like you had PT classes earlier, is it like that?
Sorry to interrupt here, but see, what I am trying to say is give equal weightage to all the subject. I'm not saying civic sense is less important and coding is more important. Both are equally important, or all the subjects are equally important. That is the whole point. But see, in any subject, context is very important. When you say coding, then you give the context to that particular learning. And when I say solving puzzle through coding and all those things, so then you have given the context of the virtual environment to that thing. See, puzzle can be solved by using the wooden toys also. Okay, but you have given, when you say grade one coding, then we have given the context of the virtual environment. So that way it helps. But it is not like that it is more important with a particular subject or not. It's completely, I'm also completely agree with you.
It is just a vocabulary, right? Yeah. It is a vocabulary which is being context taught to different. The context. Yeah, no, and not the rigor of the word coding, right?
No, yeah.
It's just a vocabulary.
Correct, okay, correct.
You so learn that is some, the wrong some thing, few actually. Words and maybe some terminologies. And you become acquainted with that, yes, right? Sir. That is what you mean. It's fine, but otherwise, the question is why every child should learn coding? The answer is no. Why should they learn? If they like it, you introduce somebody music, somebody you introduce dance, or somebody you introduce something dramatics and things like that. What they like, that they can go into that particular area and develop their skills, more skills.
Exactly.
So if coding is analogous to that situation, fine. But my personal belief is that parents need not worry about this. This is a big jargon which is being used. It might have been used in national education policy. Why they have used it? It is just to make them understand that, earlier nobody studied, Fortran and BASIC in high schools. But they started introducing that later on. Correct. So similarly, this coding is being done the same way. So I would not give importance. I'm telling you that. I would not give any importance. Coding,
it should be equal importance like any other subject, not a special thing.
Yeah. I will add here that coding is a method of communicating with the computer, what I feel, right?
Yeah.
So I think that at primary level, it should be taken as a playful activity.
Correct.
It shouldn't be mandatory for the children to learn. If you are taking it as a still primary classes, I know nowadays that children are born with the mobiles in their hand and Mr. Yadav said, in their mouth. I feel that at this tender age, we should not encourage coding as a mandatory subject. It should be like a playful activity till class 5.
Extracurricular activity.
Like puzzles and all that, interesting activity which kids would love and enjoy. But after that, of course, it can be a subject for the children, but not at such young age.
If you carefully see the NEP, up to grade 8, all the subjects are considered as an exposure only. All the subjects, not only coding. See, today, tomorrow, I can say, why do you need to teach mathematics? Or why do I need to teach history in grades? Because I'm not going to be a historian. So it is more about the exposure to all the subjects. Yes. And that is where coding has been introduced. It is, see, it is our mistake as a parent to give it as an undue respect and extra weightages. But as a subject, what government has decided, that is more in the line with the thought process. Ki up to grade standard, it is more about the exposure.
Yes.
Nothing else. See, today, the technology is so fast, like Tesla car is coming. Okay, now it is without driver. Suppose a child is seeing that car. Okay, it might be very soon visible on our roads, actually. And he will be surprised that why this car is not having a driver. He will not be able to think of, because he doesn't have that kind of exposure of like, what is artificial intelligence? How does it happen? So because future is changing so fast, it is important to teach the students, okay, this is like what is future coming up. Okay, it is about the exposure. It is not, see, we should not be hiding. This is more the information, okay, not about like making it a career. Okay, so my summary to the his question, Mamta ma'am's question is, it should be given as an exposure only, not as a subject.
Sir, Piyush Kunji here is asking us, how will coding help in real life?
Okay. Yeah, please.
Before you, can I answer?
Yeah, please, ma'am.
Okay. So, I feel that nowadays, everything is on code. Even if it's a PAN card, Aadhaar card, Google Pay, Paytm, everything, you will see the code everywhere. So, in normal life, I feel in future, it's going to help. So, according to the modernization, aane wale waqt mein, I think this will be the only thing the child needs to learn in future once they grow up. Rest on you, sir.
So, actually, when I say the real life, what is the importance of coding in the real life? Okay. I would say up to 12th standard, even now, I was thinking about whatever numerical analysis and all those algorithm or a history or geography or whatever I have learned, what is the importance and relevance of that in my career now? Okay, so under the education, everything is actually, if you take it as a relevant or not relevant, that is a very difficult question to answer actually. Okay, we will be learning so many things in our school time that if you try to find out the relevancy of each and everything, I can take it any subject and ask the same question again. Okay, that what was the importance or relevance of that particular subject? But now take it in otherwise. Every subject has some kind of skill behind it. Okay, that skill can be like your how do you explain or how do you like in the languages. Okay, so that's why there is a minimum two languages has to be selected in your curriculum. So that kind of restrictions are there. Okay, so how do you express yourself? Now coding is something which is, I put it personally between mathematics and English. Okay, this is something is you need to just a little bit patient about it. So between mathematics and English, when I say, because it has the logical reasoning and algorithmic thinking, which is basically a part of the mathematics. And in coding, you basically express yourself, your solution in the most optimized manner. See, today you might be using PowerPoint and all those things, tools basically. Okay, but tomorrow, the same thing can be expressed in the form of mobile app or website. Okay, so coding you are using as an expression also, and also you're solving a day-to-day problem also. Okay, very simple. For example, creating a timetable for the school. Okay, every teacher knows how hectic it is. Okay, it is a real challenge. Okay, to make a comfortable timetable for all the teachers with all the constraints of teachers and students, everything. Okay, so these things can be very much automated, and this has been already automated. It's not some problem which is. So in every day you are seeing the coding. Okay, you take out and your mobile in your hand, and you will see almost 10,000 codes inside this mobile app. Okay, so these things has become part and parcel of our life. We are not able to realize also. Okay, relevance is there. It is just about developing your core skills, and that is where has to be focused. Yeah.
So there's a question which Savita Sharma ma'am is asking from Ankur School, Sector 14. She's asking, apart from the teacher, what extra resources would be required for teaching coding?
It's a very good question, actually. May I? Yeah. So when you are talking about the resources, one thing you have to be very careful in your selection, you have to go with the open source. Okay, if you go with any kind of proprietary tool, so a student will not be able to practice at home. Okay, or once your contact with the company is over, you will be you have to keep on spending on your licensing fees. So you need not to learn anything which is a license cost. Okay, because anyway, our focus is not to learn the code as a language or tool. We are focusing on the skills, and skills can be learned on the Python, which is completely free. Okay, similarly, any tool like there is a lot of in the lower grades, particularly, you need to have a lot of drag and drop kind of tools and all those things that you have to use. There are plenty of open source technologies which you can be used. See, what is important is the teacher has to be trained well on how to deal it for the skills part, not the basically the language part. I'll give you one example. When we design the syllabus, it is transdisciplinary, interdisciplinary, which we, many of us know. So you have been given a geography assignment, show the rain pattern of the whole year in India or crop pattern of the India. Okay, and rather than just putting it on the map or paper or maybe PowerPoint, let's put it on the website. Okay, collect the data of last 10 years, do your own analysis and make a website which is giving this pattern. So this is like he's actually learning geography and he's doing an analysis of the geographical thing. And but he's basically unknowingly he's expressing, as Gurpreet ma'am was saying, he's expressing himself or herself in the form of coding. Yes. Similarly, English also. Okay, you can make a dictionary tool or whatever, n number of things, thesaurus or something. Okay, or any assignment can be given in the form of, like, okay, now develop it in the, write a program on it. So that way, when you make it transdisciplinary in everything, it becomes your part of the like applications also. And you need a support from your subject teacher plus computer teacher.
You know, in all these things, what should not happen is that exercises related to coding or anything else should not be a burden on the parent.
Right.
And the parent burns the midnight lamp and the kid is nicely sleeping. Right? This is what happens when many of the activities which are given to the kids,
they are actually to parents.
The parents are doing it. Really, the parents are doing it. Parents,
sir, that is a completely different problem.
No. So in coding, they must do it, they must enjoy it, and it should be like that. Okay. In fact, the artificial intelligence should find out that the parent has done it or the kid has done it.
Sir, you gave a very good idea, actually, sir. I will launch a coding classes for parents only so that they can help in their homework.
But the burden of parents has become...
No, it's a, actually, see, it's a very good with taking the lighter note. But Gidi Yadav sir, there's a very valid point. If, it is for all the subject, not only coding. If any craft activity is done, given to the student, and if parent is doing that craft activity, then his fine motor skills are not developing. It is the parent's fine motor skills are developing. So the whole purpose has been lost. So if whatever, kitna bhi ugly, whatever he's creating, let him create on his own. Don't assist. You can just be a guide. That's all. But don't assist or create for him, actually.
Actually, to make the kids smart, the best thing is to ask them to do it themselves. They might fail once. They might fail twice. But then they will build their confidence.
Okay.
If you try to help the kid, then the kid is dependent on you. So the kid doesn't get 100% marks, the mother gets 100% marks and she's happy because she has worked day in and day out. Okay. That is what is wrong with today's education. I can vouch for it, because many times in schools, the parents, particularly the poor lady mother, she is really bothered. Father may not do much help, but the mother has to do it because the kid is giving all the jobs to the mother.
Yes. So a very funny incident, I just reminded, you reminded me actually. So actually, Birla Benyas also runs the homeschooling program. And whenever like we are running a homeschooling, that's like a 2 hours class for daily, and we give them the kit also so that they can do on their own. I mean, because it's like giving the complete school environment at their home. Now, when this class start, many times we have to just keep on asking parents to go out, because they keep coming and doing those craft activity with the students. So I mean, we tell them, we are here to teach student, not to you. Please, you leave the room. So it is so, matlab, sometimes embarrassing also for us. So
particularly Indian parents are highly overindulging.
Yeah.
You know, and they will always interfere with the kids' activities, thinking that the kid is buddhu, doesn't know anything, and they are smart. And it is not wrong, but everybody thinks that the kid should stand first. There is no second number. You know, this is the problem. You know, that is the problem. So you will find, because you are from IIT system, I'll tell you, everybody who goes into the IIT, they are somewhere smart kids, they're topper there. But when they go to IIT, somebody will be number one, somebody will be number 120. So the fellow who is 120 thinks he's buddhu, right? Immediately, this psychology like that. They don't think that they're totally different and their skills are different. And there is no difference between number one and number 120. But they are made to believe that.
Correct.
And particularly in schools, the parents are responsible. I would rather give a lesson to the parent rather than to the coding lesson first. First 6 months, parents are taught coding, then only they will be relaxed.
So there's one question from Sunita Ranyalji that she's saying that Indian parents are, I won't use this word, and they used to push their children for whatever is in fashion, even if there's child not interested. What is your message on that? Yes.
I think Yadav sir has just mentioned that only.
Yeah, same.
Yeah, I said not. Don't pressurize the kid.
Don't pressurize.
I'm telling you, you know, so-called child artists are nobody in later life. I must tell you that. Sometimes we appreciate them. Oh, they are still, the child is so great. He's burnt out by the time. So in fact, many kids who go into the IIT system, they burn. The moment they get into the IIT system, they think, I have achieved now.
So if
not everybody, but majority, 70% students may be like that, because they think now they are into the system, they have got into the IIT, they don't care for anything else. So this same thing happens. The child artist, very rarely you will see that they become great afterwards, because they are already become egoistic. They have become egoistic and they have not understood the value and may become arrogant also. So what I am trying to tell you, that there may be exceptions, but majority of the cases you analyze correct. Majority of the cases, because parents only tell them, oh, you are great. So the kid always thinks that he is great. Whenever he gets up in the morning, he thinks, oh, I am great.
No, Mr. Yadav, no. I have two kids. They are not young children. Like my son is 21, my daughter is 23. They both are, they were very famous child artists.
Look, I'm not asking exceptions. I'm talking of generality. Exceptions different.
The principals should know that I did never push them for anything. I was a teacher. I wanted them to be at least a graduate, learn something in life. They did that. Okay.
So
my son is doing graduation in 4 years rather than in 3 years. But I never pushed him, because he was literally debarred from Mithibai College because of the lack of attendance. You know, I don't feel embarrassed or shy to tell here, because I have never forced my kids to do anything. Whatever best they like, I leave them on them, and they do it. And they were earning so well when they were kids. And they did. Today also they want to become actors. I never tell them that you do this, you do that. So this is for all the parents also, that please let your kids do whatever they like. Don't force them. You said it.
Yeah.
My comment was general comment, okay?
I did not know
your children.
Very important aspect which Gurpreet ma'am has raised. Her kids, she said, were earning so well even as child artists. How important is earning as a career, for the career, like earning a livelihood and how should it impact the decision making when you choose a career? Yes, sir.
May I?
Yeah. Sure.
See, when you connect the earning with the learning, okay, that's a big mistake actually. Okay, you can earn very well just by writing poems also. Okay, much better than the software engineer. Okay, so it is all about like learning, not the earning. It will automatically come if you are. You need not to worry about that. See, trust me, as a this program is being watched by the later on the by the students also, it is live streaming. Okay, all the students, I am saying, just focus on the learning. Earning will automatically come. Don't worry about the earning part. Okay, you do what you are passionate about and do the best. It can be whatever subject, it can be whatever skills or hobbies you are having. Just be passionate about it. That's all. See, I am a mechanical engineer. And my first job was coding, means in the Infosys. Okay, so you can understand that how far I have matched my passion with the education. Okay, so it is not about the earning part. Earning will automatically come. It just focus on the learning.
There are 3-4 points I have collected for coding.
Actually, just before that, when Mamta Goyal ma'am has very rightly said, earning is embedded in learning, therefore focus on learning. Very true. I interrupted.
Coding, sir knows everything better, but maine thodi study ki before this webinar, I did some study.
Okay? Please.
So these points are for the principals or and parents, those who are interested in knowing. Coding is another language. It's elaborated. I'll say only one line. Coding is
Can you speak loudly? I'm not. Yeah.
So coding is another language, okay? Yeah. And in one line, I'll say that language teaches children how to communicate and teaches logical thinking, right?
Correct.
Coding fosters creativity.
But By
experimenting, children learn and strengthen their brains. Coding helps children with math skills that we all know. Fun with maths. Coding is fun with maths.
Correct. Okay?
Coding improves writing academic performance. That's right. Coding helps children become confident problem solvers.
Correct.
But the gist is that coding should not be taught as a subject in primary classes, what I feel. So
very rightly.
You know, 100%. You know, you cannot make somebody a PhD in first standard, right? You have to go through stages.
Yeah.
So coding has to be, even if it is taught, it has to be through stages, and the child must, suppose the child says, I hate coding, accept that as a matter of fact, and
allow the
child to do something else, rather than saying that neighbor's kid is doing coding and he's great and my son is not doing coding, therefore he is not great. I think this comparison also is one of the reasons why Indian parents are many times unhappy with their kids. When they are growing, that should be taken out of their minds, because there is a stage in everybody's life. Whatever you learn as a young child, you know, it will always be helpful to you at a later date. But you must be passionate about the job which you like, you want to do. You cannot do somebody else's job, okay, when you don't like it. If you like something, you may not have studied that particular subject or discipline, but you will love it and learn it because you like it.
Correct. Okay,
so I think that is what is important for all this higher education.
Shwetang ji would be able to explain very well. I think the time is going.
Yeah.
So all the principals wants to know what you think.
I could not hear regarding what you're saying. What I think,
I'm saying that I think the time is running. So in GEST, all the principals would want to hear from you that what should be done.
Correct. So basically now I'd like to I have also written my thoughts in form of presentation, which will basically it's just a 2 minutes presentation, but it will you can take the screenshots and that will help you actually. So if Sugandha ma'am, you allow, so then I can share that presentation and
sure, sir.
Yeah. Can you see my screen?
Yeah.
Okay. So coding means what I suggest that I'll just focus on few points which as a school you should be knowing about it when you are selecting any program for the your student, and what you should not and what you should actually. Okay. So at the program level itself, it should be always associated with the skill part. Okay. So we call it coding skill, not the coding. So whatever you select, I'm not saying that you select BuildaBrainia or what. Whatever course you select, it should focus on the skill part, not the language or tool parts. Okay, because if you go with the NEP thing, what they have means why they are focusing on the child to learn coding, because they want to develop the problem-solving skills and their improved concentration. So these are the few features which, when you learn coding, see everything comes with the package. When you recite poems, your memory increase. When you tell a story, your creativity increase. Okay. Similarly, in the coding also, there is some kind of skills which is being developed, like computation skills, problem solving skills. So that's where we have to basically focus. Okay. So if your objective is clear to you, you will not make a mistake actually. Okay. And what to check when you are doing a coding program for your school, basically. Okay, just let me move this. Yeah. So curriculum should be developed as per the NEP. Okay, it should not be based on anything which is like self-developed or self-proclaimed syllabus. Okay, that should not be the approach. It should be having a pedagogical approach. At what age, as Yadav sir was telling, at the grade one or grade two, what is expected from the student? Accordingly, you have to select the content. It should not be just on the name of coding, because subject name is a little bit confusing over here, I would clearly say. So don't fall in the trap of like teaching coding at grade one using some kind of languages or tools. Okay, it should be focusing on their pedagogical approach, which is required for those primary grades. It should be having a transdisciplinary approach. And the very important for the grade six onwards, it should have a debugging session, because coding is not a subject where a student will get the their queries or confusion when you are teaching him coding. He will be confused when he will be implementing it. So when he implement, when he writes his own program, or when he solve his own puzzle, that time some mentor is required who will guide him to basically debug his approach, or tell him the better approach, alternative approach, more efficient approaches. Okay, so that part should be part and parcel of the curriculum which is being shared. Okay, and then exposure to advanced technology. I'm not saying that teach him all the robotics, 3D modeling and all those things, but he should be knowing that how these things, what he is doing, little bit small pieces, how this fits into the bigger picture. Okay, so that way. And of course, from the commercial point of view, you should be very clear that what is the duration of the total course hours. Okay, that way only you should select the thing. On the syllabus check, typically there are four levels, okay, because you have to combine the grades. So grade one and two comes into level one, then grade three, four comes in the level two, and then typically five, six, seven come in level three, and eight, nine, ten in the level four. This is also a pedagogical approach, because it is not based on the grade, it is based on the age of the student. And based on the age, what kind of skills has to be developed, accordingly these programs are designed. So focus on that, because see, suppose some student is directly first time getting exposed to the coding in the grade seven. Okay, you cannot expect him to like, he's expert in level one, two and level three. Okay, although he's going for the level four. So that's why this whole program has some kind of boundaries, okay, which has to be covered in as a previous, like a prerequisite basically, I would say. So for example, when you say the level one, okay, if you see on the top right, just one second, let me move this also. Yeah, so in the top right, the skills which is required at the primary level, it is a creativity, imagination, his patience to and attention to detail, prediction, drawing skills. So these are the skills which are required at the grade one and two. Coding, whatever in name of the subject, that should be focusing on this. So that way we have to select. So typically, how it is being taught in currently, mostly by using drag and drop, using some kind of paid software, it should not be taught in that manner. It should be using open source software rather than just drag drop and making him clap, okay, he has done it. He should think, okay, focus should be on the thinking, what to drag, where to drop and why. So why is most important aspect in the coding, and not just doing a drag drop thing basically. Okay, I'll not go into details of everything, but these are like level wise, everything has bifurcated. So I'm just putting it for some time on the screen so that later on you can pause and go through it. Okay, so same way for the level two also, it should be logic building. Okay, not anything else. Okay, one second, let me just move it. Yeah, so it should be logic building, not focusing on the, again drag and drop. Level three is web designing. Web designing is again, it should not be website creation. Website creation, hello.html is just 15-minute job, even if you give it to grade one student. Okay, and this is, I'm talking about level three, grade five, six, seven. Okay, they will do in 5 minutes. But you should not be focusing on that. It is about how they think about the user experience and UI there, because this is some like creating, means when you put a like a, which will look nice. Okay, so those kind of things basically has to be focused on the curriculum. Okay, again, it is integrated design principles. Okay, where they have to go for the customized mobile app interface, not anything which is like ready-made tools. Basically, there are a lot of ready-made tools coming through, automatically design your mobile app and website, which basically are useless actually. Okay, they doesn't serve any purpose. Okay, again, this is very interesting for the students. Okay, where they learn AI, and because here they first time teach machine to learn rather than learning from the machines, so they find it very exciting. Okay, but you have to be careful here. It should not be based on the some kind of ready-made programs. Okay, like many times ready-made algorithms are given. So as Yadav sir was telling that from the grade one nobody can be PhD. So just keep in that mind. They should develop their own thinking, their own formulas to do the analysis, rather than just going with the whatever is ready-made and being served to them as a tool basically. Okay, exposure is very important. It's, I've already covered that they should be taught, told about that, how their small snippets can be plugged together to form a bigger picture. It's no need to teach them the bigger picture, just to show them the bigger picture. That's all. Exposure is important, because then they will come back to you and they will give you the solutions which will be like out of box thinking basically. Okay, so this should be the typical learning cycle. They should go with some kind of their own debugging session and continuously doing the projects and all. They should have the queries. Okay, I'll not go through the more details because time is really less. Okay, so I'll leave it to Sugandha to take it ahead and let me just guide me what to take.
Well, here, thank you, Shwetan sir. I would like to acknowledge Ms. Gurnam Kaur Grewal, principal of Guru Nanak Public School, Sector 36 from Chandigarh. She's saying that I think if, along with theoretical and practical aspects of various subjects, if a child is taught basic values like skills of comprehension, analysis, judgment, negotiation, problem solving, communication, planning and organizational skills, team building, interpersonal skills, etc., along with values like dedication, perseverance, integrity, farsightedness, compassion, ability to work in multicultural, multi-ethnic environments, flexibility and adjustment, etc., through various projects of various subjects, including coding, group work, by trained, innovative and passionate teachers, it is going to help the child throughout his life. And she's also congratulating Times NI for organizing this webinar, which she's enjoying thoroughly. So thank you very much, ma'am, for that observation. And I would like to basically express my thanks to all the panelists here, Professor G.D. Yadav, Gurpreet ma'am, Shwetank sir, to all my colleagues in Times of India, Monica Naithani, Deep Shobha, team NIE from Chandigarh. Okay, there are a lot of people whose names, Kunal is there, Pavnendra is there, and so many others also. Vishal Sharma ji is there, Kushpreet Airi is there, we've got Sana Sachdev, my counterpart from Chandigarh, who I cannot thank enough, Anne Cherian. She is the editorial head in Chandigarh for NIE. And a lot, and above all of these colleagues, who some of whom I may have missed, I'm apologizing right now here for the missing a few colleagues' names to be mentioned here. Above all of these people, I would like to express immense gratitude to all the educators and principals who have taken time out to attend this webinar and make it successful. All of the principals from Chandigarh, I am immensely grateful and express thanks to you for making this webinar successful. Be safe, be happy, all of you. Yes, Shwetang sir.
Ma'am, whenever we go to the school, see, because this is a pandemic situation and we are not physically visiting the schools, but as a note of the gratitude, okay, from our company side also, we have something to offer to all the participants here, okay, all the principals, because right now schools are facing a big challenge to keep the student engaged. Okay, and it's like, I can't say that government is not supporting in the fees, no, but it is like government is also doing their best and the school are also doing their best, but it is a big challenging time for everyone actually. So from our side, whatever we can contribute, okay, particularly for only the participants who are here, okay, I would like to offer, means let me just share my screen so that will be easier, okay. So I would like to offer a gratitude note from here. Okay. So this is what we are, means I'm proposing to offer. As a token of gratitude, it is a free coding class for entire 1 month. Okay. That is 2 classes in a week, or they can go for the camp classes also. Okay. And this is for your students only. This will help them to keep them engaged and in some kind of creative activities when they are at home right now. Many schools are facing challenge like how to keep them engaged. So this is a small token of gift from our side. So I'll do one thing. This is form link is actually a bit difficult to remember. So I will send a separate mail to everyone and just to offer this basically as a gift from our side. Thank you so much.
So thank you very much. And we'd like to sign off on that happy note here. Thank you once again to all the principals who were present here and made this webinar successful. Thank you very much.
Thank you and take care.
Yes.
Thank you.
Thank you, Baba.
Thank you all. Thank you very much. Just stay safe.